Welcome you all in today's session. We will continue our discussion with the lecture number 5 of module 3 under the head of DCAC bridges. The very next module of subpart of this module 3 is the earth resistance measurement of fault. So these things we will discuss. In the last lecture we discussed the how you can use Kelvin double bridge for the measurement of low resistances and in what circumstances you should use potentiometer or ohmmeter. So ohmmeter and potentiometer will come later on, but ohmmeter is not in your course as far as the course content is concerned. But I would advise you to go through the detailed configuration of the ohmmeter, how it is working, and you can use Wheatstone bridge also, and for the high resistance you can use the Megger. Again, the Megger is also not in your course, that's why I try to jumble all the information at one place and for your better understanding, so that you will be able to understand that what kind of configuration or method you should use for the measurement of low resistance or high resistance or resistance, and how you can pursue that. Now it comes to the high resistance. The discussion cannot be over without talk about the measurement of earth resistance. Okay, because it doesn't matter how big your physical size or the dimension of your electrical equipment is, as far as the amount of resistance offered by any electrical equipment or machine, or you can say that the casing of the machine. Casing means basically the protecting cover, okay, the shield, outer shield of the machine, cannot be higher than that of the resistance of the earth. Because the resistance of earth is many, many, many times higher. Yes? So, just take a small assignment question, one line question, that find the range of the earth resistance. Okay, try to work out that what is the range of earth resistance in terms of ohms or mega ohms or giga ohms. Try to work out and just write down your one line answer. This is your today's assignment. Now let us come back to our discussion. So why do we need to measure the earth resistance? That is the agenda of today's discussion. So the provision of the earth resistance you can pursue with the help of by implementing, or by you can say that installing, an earth electrode, okay, for an electrical system. For each electrical system, and when I say electrical system, that means electronic system is not the separate, rather you also have to consider the electronic systems also. So under the head of electrical science, whether it is an electrical system or electronic system, doesn't matter. Each and every electrical or electronic system or device or component should connect with an earth electrode. Okay. What is the reason behind it? So first and foremost, all the part of your electrical or electronic equipment, whether you say that casing of the device or the switches, circuit breakers, you know, lead stealth, armor of the cable, okay, and tank transformer, okay, tank transformer, I hope that you understand, this is the area actually where your oil is actually preserved, and with the help of this you are going to separate the core and the outer shell part, cladding part, clear, because with which you are getting the effect of the magnetism whenever the current flows. So you know the transformer very well. So all these needs to be actually earth, and how can you earth it? You can earth it with the help of by connecting it on electrode. What is the purpose behind it? So purpose is to basically protect the critical parts or the important part, or you can say that the entire electrical or electronic system, okay, against which it is earth. Okay, or is connected, or you can say in other words grounded, the very famous term is the grounded, with the help of an electrical, earth electrode. Yeah. Now, how you can pursue that. Basically, the current operates in the protected device. You know, you might have seen everything, all these things in day-to-day life. And thus, fault of the circuits, whenever a fault or some kind of scenario, this kind of scenario, faulty scenario is experienced by your electrical electronic device, in that case, most of the time, the additional amount of current will flow through it, okay, or the very high voltage will be imparted or will be injected across that particular device. So in that case, there is a possible chances that the sensitive part of the device or the critical part of the component which is exposed to the very high voltage or the very high current flow through it, okay, could be damaged. Fine. So to protect it from that kind of accidents or that kind of malfunctioning scenario, you require to earth that particular electrical or electronic component. Okay? So that your earth electrode can ensure that in the event of the over voltage on the system, maybe due to the lightning discharge or maybe some other kind of fault, those part of the equipment, okay, which can be normally dead, not are dead, which can be normally dead as far as the voltage is concerned. So do not attend very dangerously, very high potential. Because if it will attend, then definitely it is guaranteed that those devices will be burned out within a fraction of seconds. It will disappear, simple. Okay, discard. So in a three-phase circuit, you might have noticed that the neutral of the system is on. And there is a neutral circuit because path, because to reverse of the direction of the current of flow, or you can say that to complete the circuit. Okay, or the closed path, in order to stabilize the potential of the circuit with respect to, in order to stabilize the potential of the circuit with respect to the earth. Okay. So therefore, you can say that the resistance of the earth electrode should be as low as possible. Why? Because an earth electrode will only be effective, okay, so long it has a low resistance to the earth. If it is offering low resistance to earth, what happens? There is an additional amount of current, whenever very high voltage, here, so that the relative additional amount of leakage current will not carry on by the device, rather it will bypass through that low resistance path, okay, which is connected to the earth electrode. And you know that the resistance of the earth is very, very high, so it doesn't matter how much additional amount of current you will inject to the earth, it will simply absorb it, okay, and it will help your electrical or electric device to remain protected. Yeah? So that's why the resistance of the earth electrode should be as low as possible to give good protection, visibility or scheme, and it must be measured on time to time basis or in the routine manner. Yeah? So the main factor on which the resistance of the earth earthing is depend, that is, one is the shape and size of the material, shape of the material, okay, and the material type itself, of course, through which the earth electrode is made of. Then number two, at what distance you are going to be grounded or earth, in other words you can say, that means the depth of the soil at which earth electrode is actually buried. That's why it is almost generally suggested, as you might have seen, that whenever you construct a building or your home, okay, it is always advised that you should earth as deep as possible. Okay? So the depth of the soil is does matter. Then number two, specific resistance of the soil. Because remember, as the soil texture will change, soil configuration will change, soil type will change, and the amount of resistance it can offer, okay, by that particular kind of soil will definitely change. It varies, okay. Not, it is not constant across the world. So therefore, the specific resistance of the soil, okay, surrounded to the neighborhood, okay, particularly the soil which is surrounded to the neighborhood of the, in the neighborhood of the electrode, that you required to measure, and it is not constant, remember, it always varies time to time. So for example, in the rainy season, automatically it will slash down. What is the reason behind it? Because if the moisture is, let's say, I would say that is ingress, and your moisture is 30% is added to that particular soil, additional moisture is ingressed. So because of that, what happened, it's a carrying capacity will be somehow influenced by 300 to 400% of margin, maybe almost 10 times effect. So that's why you required the periodic testing to ensure the earthing remain sensible for this. Okay, and not only this. So for example, if you talk about the specific resistance or the resistivity, which is measured in ohm meter, normally of the soil is around at the range of 80 into 10 to 3 ohm meter. Remember, it is not resistance. I asked you the resistance of the earth, okay, in the assignment question. So remember, there it is, unit is ohm. So 80 into 10 to 3 is almost in kilo ohm meters. That range you will get. Clear? For the moisture clay. That means if the surface is exposed to the moisture, and if it is completely dry, then it can be vary from almost 1000 factors. You see, notice 10 to 6 times. So it can move from 10 to 3 to 10 to 6 times. 1000 or 10 to 3 practically can be considered as an infinite. So this much variation you are getting. That's why it is always advised that do not touch the switches or your plug points in a moist hand. Okay? I mean, whenever you have a, you should always, your fingers should be dry when to connect to any electrical or electronic equipment. Because if it is not finding proper earthing, then you may feel a dangerous scenario even. Okay? So for example, as it is mentioned, a decrease in moisture content, as I have told you, if the moisture content is decreasing 30%, is capable of producing increasing 300%, that means 10 times more in a specific resistance. Okay? So that's why you require to check it regularly. Right? Now, as far as the measurement of the earth resistance is concerned, there are certain schemes available. It is not in your course in detail. I would advise you to go through these slides in a brief and to get the proper information. Number one is the follow-up potential method. Okay. So in follow-up potential method, what we have, as you can see in this particular circuit diagram, the measurement of earth resistance, okay, by follow-up potential methods. In this method, what we have to do, that a current is passed through the earth electrode. Say for example, you consider an auxiliary electrode P, okay. The two auxiliary electrode we have taken and one earth electrode taken. Clear? So inserted in a particular distance, and then the secondary electrode E is also inserted, okay, in between the earth E and B. So the potential difference, which is equal to V, the potential difference, of course, you can measure with the help of voltmeter, okay, that is between E and A is measured for the known value of current. So remember, it is known. So a current is already known. So the flow of the ground current, how it can work out, that is already shown to you. So in that case, the line of the first electrode current, okay, diverges through the secondary electrode current. And in this vicinity, the potential distribution between the electrode, okay, as you can see, that RE, let's assume that the earth resistance is measured by is represented by your terminology R subscript E. So it is V by I. With the help of that, you can measure. And what is V here? So V is basically potential difference between the E and A. So V A by I. So that's how you are able to measure the earth resistance with the help of follow potential method. Okay. So as you can understand, if you are going to vary the position of A, so what happened? V A E is going to change. So V A is going to change. I is a constant. So therefore, what will happen if E A, the distance between E and E is closer, so obviously V A is decreasing. If it is increasing, okay, if the distance is farther, so then obviously V A is going to increase. So according to your earth resistance gets changed. Okay, so remember, it is not exponentially increasing or linearly increasing. It will reach to a particular distance, and thereafter your R E will remain constant. So wherever the point you are getting the R E is remain constant, in that particular region only you should find or your earth, your so your ground and your earth electrodes, okay, to find the resistance is constant. Okay, remember it. Okay, so resistance in this part of resistance as low as possible. Clear? So even before the threshold point, even it is far better, I would say. Okay, so that's how you can pursue this particular task. Number two, the earth tester. As you can see in this particular diagram, the resistance of the earth can also be measured with the help of this earth tester, or in other words, this earth tester is sometimes, or more popularly in the electrical terminology, is known as beggar. Beggar means your mega ohm resistance. That means very a device or equipment or a tester which can measure very high resistance. Okay? So as compared to the fallout potential method, if you are going to use the meter, you require some additional devices. So for example, rotating current reversal, okay, and the rectifier device, so that you can get either irrespective of the AC input, you can get the reading across the throughout 360 degree ideally, and practically it is more than 270 degree. Yeah. So how you can do? Let us see quickly. So both of these additional features consist of the simple constructions. Okay. And as you can have been noticed over here, that P1 and P2 are nothing but these are the two terminals. Okay, of the earth testers, and the two other couple of the terminal, secondary terminal, is given by C1 and C2. Okay. And in these configurations, you can see that the rectifier is connected to the earth resistance C and the E. So what you do, that the earth tester has the four terminal, you can say that P1, P2, C1, C2, right? So the two terminal P1 and C1 are, you can say, for example, shorted. As you can see, that two terminals are shorted over here in this particular diagram to form a common point to connect with the earth electrode. The other two terminal P2 and C2 are connected to the auxiliary electrode. Okay, so for example, this auxiliary electrode P and C. So remember, this E1 in the fallout potential method is E, P is nothing but A, and C is nothing but the P. Yeah, respectively. So the indication of the earth tester or the meter depends upon the ratio of the voltage across the pressure coil. Okay, so in this case, the pressure coil you can see over here, the current coil is measured over here, potential coil. Okay, these demonstration, the electrodynamometer measurement, I have been already discussed with you. Okay, so follow that. Okay, and in this case, what will happen? Then the deflection of the pointer indicates that the resistance of the earth is direct or not. And although the meter, which is a permanent magnet moving coil instrument, okay, PMMC device, not the electrodynamometer, I'm sorry, for the corrections. Okay, so it is, though it is a, and why you are preferring the PMMC device, because of its accuracy, and you know that you can use it as a for the secondary calibration purpose also. Okay, but remember, the restriction is that it can operate only DC. Okay, yet including with the help of the reversal, current reversal, and the rectifying device, it is possible to measure the DC current also through the soil. Okay, and So with the help of this particular arrangement, okay, the instrument can be freely used, okay, or you can say that it is free from the effect of the alternative, the direct current present in the soil. So it can measure both things with the help of this current reversal and rectifier mechanism, this overhead line over use. Okay, so okay, and the DC current generator is also implemented over here. Okay, so that even if the supply is actually AC, still you can feed the DC current, because for the measurement of this particular device, device is operating on DC, remember, not AC. Okay, so with the help of this, you can use meter for the purpose of the earth resistance measurement. Okay, so I would advise, due to the shortage of time, I could have discussed this example, but I would advise that go through this particular example, try to solve it, and if you find any difficulty, you discuss with me, okay, in the next class. And other than that, in the next section class, if we are going to see that even if at all your system is going to experience certain fault, okay, in a live scenario, how would we able to measure? So for example, now you might have seen everywhere that there is an underground cable system, your power cable is actually underground. Okay, we wanted to beautify the our city area, we wanted to reduce the maintenance and operation expenditure also, because remember, installation cost of the underground cable is very high, but then the maintenance cost is extremely low. Okay, and in coastal areas, in like for example Bhubaneswar or some place where it is the chances of the you can say that the vibrant atmosphere is too much, suddenly you are experiencing the thunderstorm. Okay, so in this kind of scenario, the maintenance requirement is very, very low as if you are going to earth cable. Now the problem starts that if you are going to use the grounded cable, underground cable, for the say data communication, optical fiber, or the for the power supply, if there is a fault is occurred, then how would you able to measure it? Okay, so these things we are going to supposed to discuss in the next lecture. Yeah. Till then.